IVM.
It's been another great week on IVM Podcast. And if you're not following us on social media, please do. We're at IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, etc., etc. On our latest episodes of The Seen and the Unseen, Amit Verma is joined by author and columnist Vivek Paul to decode how the government uses and misuses data for optics management. On Puliya Bazi, Pranay and Saurav talk to author Snigdha Poonam about her new book, Dreamers. On Football Twaddle, we have Azim Banatwala as a guest with Saru Baru and Kumar discussing the end of the UEFA Champions League. And on Who's Your Mommy, Veda talks about mothers and how they cope with their constant sleep deprivation. As I said, it's been a great week, and please try and listen to as many of these shows as you can. And now, on to your show.
Hey, and welcome to Simplified.
Yeah, and in this episode, we look into why Walmart paid really, really whopping sum of money for
the to buy this little company called Flipkart.
And we go into a lot of reasons, some thought-provoking, some downright crazy. And a lot of people, approximately everybody has a theory or theories of their own, and everyone has an opinion or opinions of their own, and we just sort of wade through all of them
and try to
find out what makes sense and what doesn't. We hope you'll enjoy this journey.
And also, fun fact, this is the Simplified episode that has a maximum amount of actual research. Naren actually went out and spoke to actual living people rather than just type in a URL. So that's something. So yeah, stay tuned, and we will be right back after this to spill the beans.
Long, long ago, not in Bethlehem, but in a place nearby, there was a wonderful birth of a huge show, which I like to call Cyrus Says, a show that encapsulates everything in human history, from the first Homo sapien to the last Homo sapien, who's traversed the entire world and then come back to India. This is a show which tells you everything about everything. If you want to know, avoid Google, come to us. It's called Cyrus Says. Get new episodes every Monday and Thursday on the IVM Podcast app, website, or wherever you get your podcasts from. It's simple as A, B. Oh God, what comes after that?
Welcome to yet another episode of Simplified,
our weekly podcast aimed at making you, the listener, slightly smarter than you were when you started.
Yeah.
Slightly smarter could be, oh shit, I should not listen to another episode of this ever again. But hey, we made you smarter one way or the other, so the promise stands.
Yeah.
Only two of us this time, Naren, in the studio.
Our other podcaster, Shriket, is actually contributing to the GDP of India by working. And poor guy, he has a lot of work, so he couldn't make it.
So actually making PPTs and things, So we miss you, Shriket, and so do our listeners.
And
let's get right into this.
We are going to talk about lots of money, lots of billions of dollars. Even if we aren't making any, we can still talk about
it. Correct, absolutely, yes.
It's like most of us talk about sex.
Okay.
So, but before we do something, there is an article in our constitution
which
requires that we discuss the most inspiring profundity.
Just like in school, before you start maths, you are supposed to say the morning prayers. So, similarly, before we get into the fount of wisdom that is Simplified,
family group,
need to get into the family.
And if today people, you know, acknowledge me on the street as a wise man, and they nudge each other and say, hey, there goes a wise man, it's because I read all those family WhatsApp forwards and internalize them.
Correct.
And here is one which we would like you people to internalize. And here it is. The image is one of the Buddha sitting in the lotus pose. And it says, time decides who you meet in life. Your heart decides who you want in your life, and your behavior decides who stays in your life. And the bottom thing is ebuddhism.com.
Amazing.
And of course, as our producer promptly remarked when I told him this earlier, I guess it doesn't come with attachments.
If this was sent out to MBA aspirants, and every time would decide which institute to go to also. Let's get into the meat of what we are talking about.
So today we are going to take a good look at the Walmart buyout of Flipkart, which was all the rage last week when we are recording. And at this time, I would like to make a quick disclosure that Chuck and I were actually planning to buy Flipkart ourselves, but we decided that Walmart needed it more.
More, correct.
And plus, we were saving up to buy an iPhone X, so we didn't have the spare cash.
So, if any of you have an e-commerce company that's worth a consideration, we are taking...
Right. So, now that these important legal disclaimers are out of the way, what do you think, Chuck? Is that what they call a win-win deal for... both parties?
So instinctively I sort of think so, because when Flipkart was bleeding money, and everyone in India who's in the e-commerce space is bleeding money, so it's obviously a massive win for them and the investors and the many employees that have stuck around for so long waiting for something like this to happen. And from Walmart's point of view, they are so flush with cash, this is a quick, easy, dirty way for them to just poke their nose into India. I mean, I'm sure there's a lot of challenges ahead for them to actually make Flipkart profitable. It's basically their way of telling Amazon, hey, we couldn't beat you here, but we are going to beat you in what seems to be the world's largest and fastest growing e-commerce market anyway. So I would say it's definitely a win for Flipkart, and I would say with a win, with a little question mark for Walmart.
And that's what is dividing the analysts,
including Arnab.
Some of them think that it's a terrific everyone says it's a terrific deal for Flipkart, so that's really much of a question. But I was interested to find out when I was going through whatever was there out there on the internet, that there were actually people who felt that Flipkart could have actually got a better deal. And I was like, what are they smoking? And other people, most people, thought that Walmart got a... bad deal. So people were like nonplussed. I mean, how would you...
I don't know. I mean, any deal you can say that, if they had held out for long. I mean, it's a classic, why are you buying the iPhone 7 if you wait for one more year?
We had a neighbor, we still have it. So he has a house. It's a nice bungalow. And so his standard thing is, he hates the place and he wants to sell it and go somewhere else. But his native instinct is every time somebody comes and offers him X, he wants X plus 10%.
Yeah.
So if the guy happens to go back and talks to his uncle and all and comes back with X plus 10%, now he wants X plus 20%.
Yeah.
So for the last 15 years, this guy's been trying to sell his house and it's never gone. Because every time he wants
greed.
About 10% more. Yeah.
So greed will kill.
Yeah.
So there's some line like that. No, I forget what the statement is. Yeah. So Naren, we look forward to your...
But as is the best way to discuss complex questions is without looking at the facts. But that's the best way to. But unfortunately, I've looked too.
That's gloriously Trumpian of you.
Facts just complex. There's this line Yes Prime Minister which says Humphrey is talking about. Some country that they're having problems with, and Bernard asks him, what are the facts? And shouldn't we tell the Prime Minister the facts? And Humphrey tells him, facts just complicate things. All that the people of Britain and the elected representatives want to know is who are the goodies and who are the baddies. That's all they want. They don't know any facts.
Nothing
know
has why. Changed from the 80s.
Yeah, absolutely. It is really, the most, after the family WhatsApp group thing, the wisest piece of thing in the world. Yeah. So, here's a, I read too much about this thing.
Deal.
So, I'm just bursting with lots of facts.
Facts,
so
okay.
I can't help peppering.
Please, pepper away, season away.
Yeah. So, one thing is for sure that Flipkart is a big decision for Walmart, even for Walmart, okay?
Sure.
Because the $16 billion that Walmart is investing is completely in cash. So typically what happens in these deals is they offer stock, and when that stock offer comes, it's usually an expanded stock.
Sure. So some complicated shit like this. It's like an MBA student receiving his CTC. He knows that out of the 15 lakhs, he's probably only going to see 10 of it.
Yeah.
And the rest is some complicated floor space.
Conventional wisdom is that equity is always more expensive than debt.
Yeah.
But there are practicalities. So companies, if they just suck up suck out or, you know, push out too much cash out of the system, they suddenly find it very, very difficult to function as economic entities because, you know, you have to sell your product in the market, you have to pay your suppliers, things like that. So Walmart pulling out $16 billion in cash and giving it to these people is a big deal, even for Walmart. Right?
And like I just said a while before we recorded the show, it is actually the biggest ever e-commerce deal in the world ever. That's something else.
So that's something. And it is a lot of money. So if you multiply it by today's exchange rate, it is 1,36,000 crore rupees.
Wow. Approximately, you can buy one can of petrol with that now.
Yeah. You can buy an iPhone. No, but, you know, if you spend a crore a day, it would take you 372 years to become zero. And assuming you put all the money into one of those no interest, yeah, it will be insane. Is it good for Flipkart? So, obviously, you know, because just 2 years back, Flipkart was being marked down by valuation experts and worse by its investors. So, every time, so this is what happens when a startup is growing and it needs more money, it sells a little more of its stake. And usually what happens is every new round, because the startup has done well in the previous ones, its valuation increases. So, every fresh round of funding that it gets is usually at a higher rate. But in the case of Flipkart, it started dipping.
Going the other way.
Yeah, because they were really bleeding cash.
And what is the reason for that? Was it just because Amazon came in and they were growing very
Flipkart,
fast?
Flipkart, what these fellows were doing was they were just selling stuff below the true cost of that stuff.
Yeah. So, which has been a play for e-commerce for a very long
time. And a small catch, a very subtle catch in that is, if you lose money, money is going to become empty. That's a subtle catch. So every now and then you need more. And then, you know, you have to find people who are able to, you're able to sucker out with the promise of better things.
Yeah, sure.
And those people are harder and harder to find. Hmm. So they did.
But doesn't Amazon do the same thing?
Yeah, Amazon.
But Amazon has money.
Yeah, Amazon has money, and I really haven't. They're suddenly doing very well now, Amazon. And Amazon has a number of businesses. In its, you know, it's got into entertainment, it got into web services. Amazon Web Services is a big thing.
It's actually the most profitable division of the company. Yeah.
So Amazon is doing pretty okay. But Amazon is also losing money hand over fist.
Okay, is a bit of an understatement for
Jeff, if you're listening,
Jeffy,
nothing personal, do well, Jeff Bezos, who's a regular listener of our show,
guest also once.
We should get him actually one
day. Jeff, if you're listening, it's an open invitation.
Innocently, and he might just come.
Anyway, what are we saying?
So, 2 years back? Yeah, so 2 years back, everyone was rubbishing them and, you know, obituaries were being written.
Yeah.
And a lot of leadership changes were happening. A lot of people were simply... One of the things that I sort of learned from people who are doing business through Flipkart, merchants who were selling Flipkart, was it had become hideously bureaucratic at one point. I don't know how it is now, but... they had their business carved out into different segments.
Sure.
And if your product was something which spanned two segments, you would suddenly have to deal with two different departments who would be sort of fighting each other.
Oh, so that's interesting. You've actually spoken to people who have sold on Flipkart.
Yeah. So I know a couple of people who sell merchandise on Flipkart in a fairly big way. I mean, several crores a year. And they had very, this is about a couple of years ago, and they had a very bad opinion about how it was becoming a very
bureaucratic
behemoth. But then, of course, they righted themselves. They realized, that things were not going right. This is what happens when companies grow organically.
Yeah, yeah.
And suddenly, you know, you have one guy who's handling a lot of work, and suddenly there is so much work he can't handle, you get another guy, and the systems don't change.
Right.
And then all of a sudden you find that, you're actually doing very, very badly. So that was what was happening at Flipkart just about 2 or 3 years ago. And it was showing in the entire, you know, outlook of the organization. Investors were getting very jittery about whether these people would be able to pull it off. One person whom I know, who's an investment banker and who follows the e-commerce industry.
I was hoping you'd say follow Simplified, but that also works.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah, that also, I think, I hope. And he told me that 2 or 3 years ago, every morning he expects to see an announcement saying that Flipkart is now going to close. They were losing that much money.
Wow, okay.
But they were obviously able to find enough people to have faith in them.
Sure. I mean, they still are the number one e-commerce player in the country.
But even so, their valuation, which was about $10 billion last year, okay, is now $20
billion. Yeah.
Which is tremendous news for them.
Yeah.
So, on the whole, everyone seems to agree that Flipkart got a very good deal out of the whole thing, except for a few naysayers who feel that an IPO would have been a better
option.
Better option. And I asked a few people what they thought, and general opinion.
We've done a lot of research for this episode.
Yeah, I've actually spoken to people.
This
and I was really like, you know, the first thing like in everybody's mind is if somebody can pay $20 billion for Flipkart, what can I come out with if somebody will pay me even like $200,000 also chalega? Let me come out with something. Yeah. But of course, it doesn't work that way. Flipkart has, jokes apart, created a lot of,
There was a time when I was a big Flipkart fan because everything that they were doing seemed to be like... Yeah. I think they were very... I wouldn't say that they had the Midas touch, but I think they were very
brave. They still are good. So I do buy... They're terrific at appliances. So I bought a TV from them. I bought a refrigerator. I bought
AC
some phones.
Is from Flipkart,
And they were consistently cheaper than Amazon.
Mm-hmm.
Their deliveries are fantastic. In one case, I think we had a TV which was... faulty or something like that. The thing was excellent. I had a similar issue with something I bought from Amazon. I had to make like 10 phone calls. Uh-huh. They did whatever was required. Flipkart, it just, it was very, very smooth. So their systems were good, at least when I
interacted. And I think, they were the guys who took COD in a big way. Apparently, they were one of the first company to do it.
Yes.
There was an old company back in 2002 or something. I forget which the company is who actually did a beta. Imagine back in 2002, cash on delivery.
Yeah.
But Flipkart are really the guys who...
FabMart?
Something like that. FabMart, Fab one of those early guys who died an early death, much before its time. But Flipkart were the guys who popularized cash on delivery. Mm. They did a lot of things actually that were interesting. If you remember, there was this service called Flight, an MP3 download service called Flight, which was way before iTunes in India. They were the guys, they were pretty much the first guys to offer legal music downloads in India. Unfortunately, that didn't work very well for them.
Yeah.
I don't think iTunes makes Apple any money, but it's just that Apple is Apple and they can afford to... foot the bill.
Indulge
on
these
the, they did a lot of interesting things. They were also a very cool company, back in. I mean, they lost the cool factor a little mid 2014 or so. But they used to be very savvy on social media. They used to be very spunky company. Their emails were fun. And Flipkart just was a source of pride for many Indians. And it still started, like Amazon, they also started selling books.
This deal ended in a lot of happiness for just about everyone. So there were two venture capital firms, Accel and Tiger Global, which had invested more than 8 years ago when Flipkart was valued at 50 million.
50 million.
50M. And they have now exited with more than 400 times of what they invested.
Wow.
Right? And good old Masayoshi Son, of SoftBank.
Good old SoftBank.
He invested $2.5 billion in August 2017 for a 20% stake. And he's exiting with $4 billion now.
And that's personally? Personally or SoftBank?
I think SoftBank, but I don't know how much of a difference there is. He only decides how much he takes and how much he passes on to his investors. And yet, as I was saying, there are people who are talking about IPO would have been a more meaningful exit.
Right.
And as I was saying, I spoke to some people and they say that the IPO wouldn't have given them this kind of valuation because the investing public is a very crass materialistic creature and they would look for returns. And in the case of Walmart, they were not looking just for the returns. And that's the story. And we'll look at this after the break.
Yep.
And we will discuss the very important question of what Walmart was smoking when they bought Flipkart.
All right. See you on the other side of the break.
Hello there. My name is Naveen Narona. And as a gay person in India, I get asked a lot of stupid questions.
Beta, is it LGBT or eligibility?
How do two men procreate?
Bro, is Grindr better than Tinder or what?
We answer all these questions and much more on my podcast, Keeping It Queer, where I talk to individuals from the LGBT community in India and learn about their personal stories. Catch all the episodes on the IVM podcast app or any other podcasting app you like. Till then, keep it queer.
So, welcome back. And here we go again. And now the question is, what was Walmart smoking when it bought Flipkart, right? So the question is asked because many people, including the shareholders of Walmart, seem to think that it wasn't a great idea because Walmart shares just tanked quite a bit after the deal was announced. And they lost some $10 billion USD in market cap in just about a day.
Wow. Right? Okay. So that's 50. That's 20 billion for Flipkart.
Yeah.
10 billion of market share.
But when I spoke to other people, they pointed out that Walmart sales apparently are 500 billion US per annum. That's the sales. I can't even imagine.
That's half a trillion.
Half a trillion. That is what this, that the sales. And their operating profit on that, because their model is very, very lean, right? Very small profit.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's 21 billion. So they make $21 billion a year. So 20 billion, what they paid.
And they still have a billion left over.
Yeah,
they can buy Ambani's house. Yeah. Flipkart plus Ambani's house package deal. They can buy. And they'll be broken even for the year.
Yeah. So, that's one thing I heard. Then the other thing that I heard was the Amazon story. So apparently, Amazon, you know, there used to be this little video that used to float around on WhatsApp. A monkey on a tree, swinging from a tree. And there's some tiger sitting behind. So whenever the tiger is not looking, the monkey jumps from the tree, pulls the tiger's tail and then goes up again. And the tiger is trying to catch the monkey. So it can't do that. Because the monkey is far more nimble. And Amazon did that. So Amazon was this upstart company and Walmart had an enormous physical presence. It has some gazillion stores all over the United States and huge ones. And Amazon had virtually nothing, right?
And actually, had virtually everything.
Yeah, really nothing, but virtually everything. And they were very, very savvy and they started taking over retail and they really sucked out a lot of retail from Walmart. So a lot of categories that Walmart was a leader in were just taken away by.
Yeah. And so, that's not to say what Amazon did to everybody who was not a Walmart. The number of stores, I mean, Barnes and Nobles and whatever.
Yeah. And they really took over because then Walmart became a grocery company more than anything else. And that started hurting them. And there was really nothing. So one of the things that Walmart model is it takes the whole thing end to end, right from the, it takes the supply chain right from the start, from the first guy who manufactures something till the last point. They own everything. They make, optimize everything. They squeeze out all the fat from everything and they deliver that thing to the consumer at the cheapest possible price.
And anyway, the stores are also on the outskirts, so they don't have to pay prime
city. Every single thing adds to that thing. The goal is very clear. Whatever we sell is at a price that no one else can beat.
Match,
And online, that was really, you know, they suddenly didn't know what to do. Because they were just controlling the supply chain, and Amazon was just a marketplace. So anyone who felt that he could sell, he would come and sell.
Yeah.
And purely by laws of probability, you would always have someone or the other who was really good at something and was able to do a, and it really beat Walmart. And the other thing about about Amazon is, because of the online nature of their business, you got a lot of reviews about things. At least in the US, Amazon reviews are very widely read before someone influences people's buying behavior. And that's not there on Walmart. You go to a Walmart and you want to buy a toy.
Yeah.
You have no clue if it's good or not. You take it.
On that note, it's also extremely SEO friendly. Sorry, it's very search friendly. The chances are you may not even be looking to buy it online, but you might just be searching for whatever.
Yeah.
iPhone, whatever review, some headphones review, or for that matter, even some obscure rock and metal album. And Amazon is by default somewhere in that first page.
Yeah.
Purely by nature of all the reviews and everything. So
but the simply the amount of volume of buzz that
there
is on the internet. So Amazon ads. So Walmart's always been trying to get in on the action online, and it didn't have any know-how. It didn't have any expertise.
A very clunky
internally.
Way of going about it.
It took over a company called Jet.com some time ago. In a much touted big deal, $3 billion or something like that. But that doesn't seem to have worked for them either. And this Flipkart thing, partly the deal was because Flipkart, even with all its, the fact that it loses money and everything, they are actually doing better than Amazon as far as market share is concerned.
Yeah.
So, and apparently, India is the only significantly large marketplace where this is the case. Everywhere else, Amazon is number one wherever it enters.
Yeah, that's pretty true.
Yeah, and here they've been trying and trying and trying, and they still haven't been able to upset.
Usurp.
So that was one. And the main problem, of course, we went over it a little while ago with the Flipkart model, is that this leadership position is maintained by the highly sophisticated strategy of selling things below the cost, which is brilliant, except that it suffers from one subtle flaw, that is, paisa khali ho jayega. That is the problem. So the problem with for Walmart is, they're not going to be able to do anything about it. And at least till the course corrects after a certain amount of time, or they're able to, if and when they're able to course correct, they're going to keep having to pump in money to keep the ship sailing and to defend their
basically.
So that also is going to hurt Walmart. So not only are they out of cash, or you know, they're reasonably like out of cash, they're going to keep having to pump in more. And the markets are not going to like it very
much. But for that matter, so will Amazon. So now what you have is a case of two big players in India.
Yeah, one of those cage matches.
Both of them are pretty much coming from the same, like they have seemingly indefinite pockets. They act as huge VCs in a way that just going to keep funding discounts. So buy stuff online while you can, while the party lasts, is all I can say.
And the fun thing is, Walmart also figured this out on their own. And they themselves declared that the purchase would reduce their overall net income by at least $750 million this year and by $1.6 billion next year. So they've already declared that more than $2 billion they're going to pump in just to keep
this. Yeah, but then their annual profits is, that's one-tenth of their annual profits.
Yeah, so, but $2 billion is, I don't know, 14,000 crores.
Yeah. That's a lot.
And I don't think Flipkart sales are that much. So they're like, how much is Flipkart's sale? Some $4 or $5 billion or something like that. Yeah. So 50% of the sales will come in just like that. Anyway, so the other effect, the other reason is that people believe, some people, that, you know, there is far more depth in Indian retail. And you're really counting only on the state of things as they are today. And they're going to be an order of magnitude bigger very soon. So,
yeah, I mean, there is some truth to that. Like India, for the longest period of time, had it was very interesting. If you look at the total number of people who had access to the internet, just in terms of sheer numbers, absolute numbers, we were third in the world. And I think we are second in the world right now after China. We've overtaken the US. At the same time, the internet penetration in the country, which is out of 100, how many people have access to the internet, was actually one of the lowest in the world. It used to be at around 11-12%, and then now it's hovering around 24-25% thanks to the effort of said $1 billion staying gentleman. So now both of these are extremely interesting. You have, on one hand, you have the second largest internet population in the world, and at the same time, you still have only one-fourth of the country is still connected to the internet. So just look at the, you know, potential over here. See why, I mean, these numbers are the reasons why so many investors and now companies are pumping money into
India.
And
they're notoriously difficult to quantify. Yeah. So
This is true.
So world famous investment banking firm, Morgan Stanley, estimated the online retail market to be 120 billion by 2020, about 2 or 3 years ago they came up.
As the Indian market, right?
Yeah, Indian market. And then as it inched towards 2018, and the figure wouldn't exceed more than 15 or 20 billion, they've sort of changed that date to 2026. So now they say that it'll become 200 billion in 2026. So it's a bit like Achhe Din. You know, it's coming, abhi nahi, next week aayega. Bas, just, yeah. So it's getting, and so it's notorious. So I mean, Morgan Stanley does this for a living, and even they aren't able to put figures out which are anywhere close to what happens.
But then that's that's Morgan Stanley for you.
It's notoriously difficult. But the fact remains that the numbers are enormous. We simply have a hell of a lot of people, and it's like a slumbering giant, and you don't know how big things will be when this whole thing becomes into a, you know, turns into a movement. And there are other theories as well. So theories about why people paid so much money for Walmart.
For Flipkart.
For Flipkart. Why Walmart paid so much for Flipkart. And my favorite one is that Narendra Modi, when he went in 2014, he did his America thing and met up top US CEOs. So one of the guys he met was Walmart CEO Doug McMillon. And
hence, Doug, you know, there are at least 50 WhatsApp messages that have come out of this one.
So everyone, some people believe that that's the case, in which case, good, good for Modi. And personally, if you ask me,
and
the other thing is the organized retail market, which is like not the e-commerce market. The e-commerce is part of the organized retail market, but the non e-commerce, that the what do you call it, the real
mom
world
the brick and mortar
brick and mortar thing is 10 times bigger than the e-commerce even today in India. And the unorganized retail, which is not the big shop, the mom and shop stores, the baniya stores, are supposed to be 10 times bigger
even
than
that.
So basically, e-commerce has a potential to increase 100x as things stand.
So in that regard, spending 1/40th of your annual profits doesn't seem like all that much of a...
And then there is this very interesting thing about FDI in retail investment. So one of the things that Walmart was trying to do is come into India and do its thing in India, what it was doing in the US, basically own the entire supply chain and deliver goods at a very cheap price. And they couldn't do that because FDI at that time was capped. So you couldn't come into FDI. Yeah. Then later they removed those caps, but they put in conditions. So they wanted 30% to be local.
Locally
a lot of conditions.
That,
and Walmart decided that they couldn't meet all those conditions and deliver their promise, whatever they, you know, they really want, they really believe that they have to deliver goods cheap. And with all those restrictions, they said there's no way. So the only place where those restrictions don't apply even today is online retail.
Right.
So some people say that that is why Walmart is getting into Flipkart.
Sure.
Is they want to get into retail where they can own the entire supply chain.
Mm-hmm. That's a good theory, actually. That's a damn good theory.
Yeah, they can't get into physical because of all the FDI conditions.
Yeah.
They can get into online, but they don't want to set up a new online again. So the best thing for them
exactly
is to
why bother going through the headache?
And
for all you know, when rules do change in the future, it gives them an excellent vantage point from which to move from online to offline. Actually,
and they get a lot of the expertise and learning that Flipkart has acquired from being in the market for 10
for
years.
For so long, Just imagine starting.
Small details like how do you interact with logistics company?
Right.
How do you collect money? How do you make sure it's a large and not an easy to transport to country? Like if you want to go to, if your goods are in Bombay and you have to send it to Calcutta, it could take days.
Right.
So how do you manage your inventory, stocks?
It's a damn complicated country.
Yeah, it's very, I'm sure there is a lot of expertise that Flipkart has, and maybe that also contributed a little bit to. So yeah, to summarize this, these are the main reason, and of course the possibility that they were smoking something potent is not yet ruled out till we actually get hard evidence for that. But it looks quite possible that it might have been a very good savvy decision on their part.
Correct. Also numerology could also have played a part. Mart, cart. So maybe that could also be a thing. Cannot rule that out. It's
so we have to compose a song in which Mart, cart and the other word which starts with F and
Right. On that so, note. Interesting. So as consumers, I'm assuming we can look forward to gala time.
Yeah, we will definitely benefit with all those billions and gazillion dollars that are going to come in.
Yeah.
And get ready to buy a lot of stuff that you don't need because it's cheap.
The good times just continue.
And
they used to say about the Australian bowling attack back in the 70s, if Lilly don't get you, Thompson will.
Yeah.
So there's something like if SoftBank don't get you, then Walmart will.
So, yeah, it's, I hope you've
learned a little bit about
the
deal.
Though we are most regretful that we weren't able to exactly tell you what they were smoking, but
hopefully our undercover third podcaster CK is on that right now as we speak. This is why he couldn't be over here.
Yeah.
We'll report back very soon. If you have any theories, do let us know.
Yeah.
So, goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye,
see you next
see you
week
next
for
week.
A shorty.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
There she stands, a podcast addict. Outside the bank, having traveled several miles to get in with other poor souls like her. The journey, though daunting for this youngling, will have some comfort because she has downloaded her favorite podcast. You can see more of her species on ivmpodcasts.com, your one-stop destination where you can check out the coolest Indian podcasts. Happy listening.